Hey everyone, and welcome back to Endangered Crypto. We've got another update today from the Cryptoblades team with information about what's going on with the funding of their rewards pool, their ad campaign, changes to their economy, and so on. So we're going to jump into it and see what it all means. So item number one, the ad campaign. So let's clarify what that means. No, they're not spending money on ads. That's the first thing that I thought as well. They will be adding Google Ads and other private paid sponsored ads to the website, which I think is a great idea, but I do hope that they don't overdo it. But if the ads do perform really well, that could be a great source of income for the rewards pool. It's creative. I like it. I would like it even more if we could see some transparency on how much income is being generated. They'll also be talking to direct sponsors and advertisers, and that could be another really good source of income. In fact, I think it would be really interesting if we could see some sponsored equipment or sponsored gear. What do you guys think about the idea of having sponsored equipment? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. So that's it with regards to refilling the rewards pool. It's a good start. Right now there's nothing in the rewards pool, so anything that starts putting money back in is really helpful, and I hope that we'll start to see an increase in the rewards as a result of this. And they mention it here, that they expect to see that it will increase rewards by a noticeable margin. So I hope that we'll see that come on soon. They'll probably have to wait a week or a couple of weeks to generate that income, get a payout from Google before they start putting it into the rewards pool. But it's good news. Better rewards are coming. Now, let's get into the economy adjustments, because I'm sure some of these are going to be controversial. First and foremost, they are raising claim taxes to 50%. Ouch! That is going to be very painful, but it's also necessary. What this does is this keeps more skill in the system. It's going to slow the withdrawals, because who's going to want to withdraw at, 50% tax, especially with the current reward to gas fee ratio. Again, if they increase the reward fees, we might be making 30% profit, 20% profit, but you're still losing money if you withdraw it with that 50% tax. But what this does mean is that if it does take longer for us to withdraw the skill is sitting in the economy for a longer period of time, which means it's less strenuous on the rewards pool. And it also means that they can potentially increase the rewards that we're getting without it being withdrawn so quickly. So I'm guessing the idea behind this is they're planning to up the rewards. They might even up them right away without waiting for the Google Ads, like I said earlier. But because we can't withdraw them we can, but not without taking a loss for at least 40 to 50 days, that gives them time to build up the rewards pool, get those Google Ads up and running, get that money into the rewards pool, as well as launch other things that might stimulate the economy, but we're still engaging with the game, we're still playing profitably, but they don't have to pay us right away. So bad news for some, especially for those that rely on this as a source of income. Good news for those of us that are waiting for better news, but it's bittersweet. I won't say it, but they got to do what they got to do. And I think it's a step in the right direction. Next, staking of unclaimed funds will be removed. This one really sucks. I think this one sucks more than having the tax increased, because with the tax, you're still getting your funds at the end of the day. But with the removal of staking, those funds are sitting there for up to 50 days and you can't do anything with it. We can't stake it to try and get a little bit more. You can't withdraw it. So it's basically stuck there for almost 2 months. I think the 20% discount for forging, reforging is not bad. Whether this is good or not really depends on how much they increase the rewards. If I'm making a 10% profit on my battles and then I have to think about whether I want to use those funds to improve my weapons, it's not really enticing. But if I'm making 30, 40% profit on my battles and I want to put that into forging and reforging my weapons because, you know, buying 10 weapons with the funds that I generate from battles is a lot easier because my rewards are really good. I feel more comfortable doing that and then reforging those weapons than if I'm just getting drip-fed my rewards and it takes me a whole month to pay for a weapon. I'm not going to want to pay for that weapon and then reforge it. But if rewards are a little bit more liquid, I feel a lot more comfortable doing that. And I'm happy to reinvest in the game, but I need to feel like the rewards I'm getting are worthwhile to keep reinvesting in the game. They do mention here that the tax will be reduced as features are going to be released. Raids, PvP, additional skill shop item, merchandise, character burning, marketplace rebranding. So again, this really does tell me that the skill tax is there to reduce the initial pullout while they get things in place, as they put more things in place that stimulate the economy, gets more money into the game, they're going to reduce the tax. And a few things here that I think could work really, really well is the merchandise store, it's the marketplace rebranding. I really like this approach because it's not whale dependent. One of my big worries is that the game will become too whale dependent to finance the game, and I think that will skew things a lot in favor of the whales, make it less fun, make it less enticing. With these ideas, like the Google Ads, like the merch store, it relies more on the overall community. It relies, you know, even if whales do want to purchase merchandise, it doesn't have a material impact on the game and on the potential earning, but it allows all of us to benefit from that. So I think that those are really great ideas. Again, the advertising, it benefits from the community, the time we spend on the website, whether we're interested in what the advertisers have to offer. And, you know, you could be a whale, you don't have to be a whale. Your actions contribute to the health of the economy, and we all benefit from it. So I really like these ideas, and I think that it's a great direction that the game is going. So, yeah, so those are the latest updates from Cryptoblades. I know for most of us, it's not the news we wanted to hear. Most of us are just waiting on when are they going to fix the Oracle? When are they going to fix the rewards? I don't think that's going to happen for a little while, at least a couple of months before we're back to where we used to be. There's a lot of work that needs to be done to fix the economy, but you know they seem to be taking the steps in the right direction. What do you guys think? Are you happy with the news? Do you think the game's going in the right direction? Leave a comment in the section below. Thanks so much for tuning in. I hope you guys have a good one, and we'll catch you on the next one.